Hey, welcome to the Daily Trip. Today I'm going to be talking to you about circadian rhythms. I'm going to be talking to you about your sleep cycles and how your sleep cycles or how deep meditation will directly impact and change your life, raising your energetic vibrations, raising your frequency, expanding your aura. But I also have a challenge for you. And especially for you subscribers, those of you that are subscribing, those of you that are watching every day, I have a challenge for you. And it's going to be an exciting one. I hope you enjoy. So, your challenge. Coming in a minute. I'm going to share that challenge with you in 1 minute. So hang on. Make sure you're watching through all the way through because this is really going to be important. It's going to be a lot. It's going to be a challenge, but it's going to be also fun. It's really going to shift your existence. It's going to expand your consciousness. We human beings are really struggling to sleep. We have never in the life. The life of human history needed so much sleep medication. People are continually having to use all kinds of means and methods to sleep. And a lot of the reason why is because they're stressed out, they're anxious, the like. You can check out a video on overcoming stress, anxiety, and fear right here. One of the other ways we overcome stress and anxiety and fear is through meditation. Meditation is awesome. I've been practicing various types of meditation for really over 20 years. And I've practiced and played with so many different types of meditation, breathing exercises, and experimented with my body in almost every way. Because I recognize this, that your body is an avatar. It is an energetic expression of your divine nature. And as an energetic expression of your divine nature, it has all of this innate potential, all of this amazing, innate, supernatural, superhuman potential. The reason why we're not experiencing all of this potential, we're not experiencing all of these supernatural feats and things that the body is capable of is because the body has forgotten. It's entered into a system, a systematic way of doing things. It's entered into a system that has ultimately caused it to become fat and lazy and unhealthy. And as I talked about in yesterday's video about living foods and the importance of living foods and the importance of intermittent fasting and that sort of thing, like there are lots of different ways that we can overcome these issues. Right now, our culture, our society is struggling with diabetes like crazy. I was talking to a couple of diabetics yesterday, and they were like, well, I can't fast because I'm on diabetes. Yes, consult your physicians and whatever you need to do before fasting. I have to tell you that, but in actuality, I really don't necessarily think you need to. But here's the deal. If you practice, like, well, it just runs in my family. No, the shit doesn't run in your family. It runs in your mind. It runs in your mind. You have been convinced that diabetes runs in your family. Cancer runs in your family. You've been convinced that you have to get 8 hours of sleep a night. You've been convinced that this is the way things have to look. The truth is they don't have to look any certain way. And we can overcome all these things. I have spent many years playing with, and one of those things that I've been playing with is sleep. I have slept more than 10 hours a night at times. I've slept none, zero, and I've slept the polyphasic sleeping where I've slept, two, three, maybe 4 hours in little 20-minute naps. At one point, I was sleeping 2 hours, waking up. Another point, I was sleeping 2 hours and then doing naps. Another point, I just did 20-minute naps. I did like 4 20-minute naps a day, and that's all I would sleep. And my production skyrocketed during those times because I had so much extra time, and a lot of that time was in the middle of the day. For those of you that have not woke up with the sun lately, fucking A, baby. Listen, man, it is a trip waking up with the sun. Get high, practice some heaven's manna, enjoy the, oh man, it's so beautiful waking up early in the morning. It's so peaceful, it's calm, it's quiet. You know what? If you're waking up and you're just going straight into a busy day, I strongly encourage you, wake up 2 to 3 hours before you have to move, before you have to do things. I don't care if it actually sacrifices some of that sleep. You're probably not sleeping deeply anyway if you're going that hard. So, which I'm going to talk about here in a second. But here's the deal. Give yourself the time to really wake up, to really spend some time meditating. Give yourself some time to practice some breathing techniques. Give yourself some time to energetically start moving, practice some tapping and whatever. I'm going to talk about that later in the week. But some chi tapping, which is a lot of fun. But if you want to raise that physical frequency, I'm going to give you right now, I'm going to give you a couple things that you need to do, and then I'm going to present the 420 challenge to you. Okay, it's going to be a lot of fun. So here's the deal with sleep. You don't have to sleep at all. Your body actually doesn't have to sleep. Now, I know scientists and stuff will tell you you need to get 8 hours of sleep, 6 to 8 hours of sleep, yada, yada. Great. I'm not trying to say that their studies aren't accurate. What I'm trying to say is that you don't have to be just like all those that are being studied. If you're studying a normal human body, I would agree with you. And if you're in a place where you haven't been able to practice deep meditation. See, deep meditation, here's the deal with sleep. When you enter into sleep, you're moving through these various brain waves, right? The REM stages, right? And delta brain waves are the dreamless state, deep sleep. That happens in deep sleep. And that is really important for the repair of your cells and the repair of your body, the healing of your body. Your body is meant to completely heal it, regenerate. Did you know that you can actually transform your physical anatomy every day? If you didn't, you do now. You can, like Jesus, my guru, completely transfigure your body. Completely transfigure your body. And that's some of what I'm talking about this week in raising your physical vibration. Because when your physical vibration is raised, you are entering into a light state. That light state is able to move and it forms. It's kind of like water. Picture water. Water can fit into any form, but it does not become that form. First of all, if you've identified as the form, you're not going to transmute the body. But if you recognize you are not the body, then you can begin to, transform the body. If you recognize you're not the avatar, not the body, then you can begin to really play with and transform the energy of the body. For some information on that, check out the video. So, here we are, and if you're not good, you haven't been practicing meditation, especially deep forms of meditation, and then you need to get some good sleep. To get good sleep, you must overcome some of those things. So you should fear, anxiety, doubt, worry, all those things, and so that's important. But practicing meditation will actually help you sleep. But here's something that's really bigger than that. We need to begin to shift the body. We need to pull it out of its comfort zone. So if you're used to going to bed at a certain time and waking up a certain time, your circadian rhythm is kind of set. What if I told you that you don't have to experience jet lag when you fly across the country? I have flown across the country and around the world without jet lag. How? How did I do it? I did it because my circadian rhythms, I am responsible or in control of the circadian rhythm. The circadian rhythm is not in control of me. And so the more that we practice some of these techniques if you practice some of these techniques that I'm giving you, the more that you begin to overcome those circadian rhythms. Maybe I'll do a video later on just overcoming those circadian rhythms, especially for those of you that travel a lot. I really believe that'll be beneficial. All right, so here, let's get to the 420 challenge. The 420 challenge is this. I want, especially for those of you that are subscribed, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe right now. What in the world are you doing watching a video for over 8 minutes and you haven't subscribed? Hit the fucking subscribe button, click the bell for notifications, and trip out with me every single day, okay? So, for those of you, what we're going to do is we're going to, at 4:20 a.m. and 4:20 p.m. every day, we're going to trip together. So, for 1 month, it's June 1st. From June 1st to July 1st, we're going to trip together every day, 4:20 a.m., 4:20 p.m. We're going to wake up in the morning, 4:20 a.m., and if you want to wake up and get up, then I strongly encourage that. But if not, wake up at 4:20, and for 4 minutes and 20 seconds, set a timer, Tell Siri on your phone to set a timer for you, or set a timer on your phone, on your Android or whatever, for 4 minutes and 20 seconds, and you're going to practice Heaven's Manna. Heaven's Manna video is right here. For more on that, I'd strongly encourage you to watch it. I'm going to kind of give you a brief rundown right now, but I'd strongly encourage you to watch it to kind of get the fullness of it. But Heaven's Manna just looks like this. It's a breathing exercise slash meditation that just looks like this. What we're doing is we're relaxing our body. We're going to sit up, and we're going to give all of our attention to our the pineal gland, the third eye, the prefrontal cortex. We're going to shift all the brain's energy, all the body's energy to this part of our body. So when we breathe in, our in-breath and out-breath are through the nose. We're going to relax our entire body. We're going to breathe in deeply through the nose. And while we're breathing in, our eyes are going to be, and our mind and everything is going to be focused on the breath coming into the brain and all of the energy right here. And we're going to hold for a 3-second count. You're going to hold for a 3-second count, and then you're going to release and hold for 1 to 3 seconds at the bottom. And then breathe in, hold for a 3-second count, and then release. And you're going to do that. So it's going to look like this. And you're giving all your focus, all your attention right here. You're going to actually begin, a lot of you will feel a little lightheadedness, a little euphoric feeling, especially after 4 minutes and 20 seconds of it. So 4:20 a.m., set your alarm for just before that. But wake up, 4:20 a.m., trip out with me, do a 4:20 meditation or a Heaven's Manna meditation. And then at 4:20 p.m., I strongly encourage you, that's every day, that's when our daily trip video comes out. At 4:20, do your Heaven's Manna and then watch the video. Do the Heaven's Manna and then watch the video. That's the 4:20 challenge. And what it's going to begin to do, especially at 4:20 a.m. time, is going to begin to help wake you up and start to break up some of those cycles so that we can begin to change our physical anatomy. And so here's what's happening, especially the sleep cycles. If you've gotten into a comfort zone in a sleep cycle, you might feel like, I'm getting good sleep. But if you've gotten comfortable, if your body's gotten comfortable, you actually feel like you're getting good sleep, but you might not actually be healing your body and doing as much for your body as you should. I do strongly, especially for those that don't practice meditation, encourage 6 to 8 hours of sleep. But, I think it's just as valuable, and scientists aren't going to necessarily agree with me on this, but I think it's just as valuable for you to begin to shake the 6 to 8 hours of sleep and change it up, shift it up. Change the times that you go to sleep. Change the times that you wake up a little bit. Now, it's going to fuck with your anatomy. It's going to fuck with you at first. You're going to feel energetically different at first. But you take a power nap, you hit a 20-minute power nap, or whatever you need to do throughout your day. What's happening is you're changing the circadian rhythms. And so your body doesn't really know what to do. There's this clock, this rhythm, this clock in your brain that basically says, this is when I need to go to sleep based on the sunrise, and this is when I need to wake up. It was originally based on sunrise and sunset. And so ancient people would always wake up with the sun and go to sleep with the sun. Here's the deal. When we start to break those circadian rhythms, you feel a little drained at first, but what we're doing is we're actually training the mind to awaken some of these divine attributes. God does not sleep, doesn't need to, and is not bound by a timeline or a rhythm. And so our bodies can actually enter into a divine rhythm, a divine flow, instead of a physical one. And so instead of existing within that physical flow alone, we're entering into more of a divine flow. I'm going to talk more about this later, but what this is ultimately going to do is if you practice this for a month, you're going to start to see a change, and you're ultimately going to raise that physical vibration, and you're going to start to see that you can experiment with your sleep a bit more, and you'll actually start to enter into more of the healing states of sleep, the important ones, the really important ones, and you'll sleep better, and you'll sleep more regularly. And it will really change your life and raise your vibrational frequency, awakening that divine nature, awakening the avatar. I love you. Remember, trippers, the more you awaken, the more you fucking play. We'll be right back.